Yeah, it's obviously really good news that that's been cleared up in terms of clarity. And also, he's obviously got a coach with a fantastic record all around the world. And, you know, the guys are just looking forward to him coming over now and getting stuck in. He's a successful coach. So everywhere he's gone, he's been successful. His one-day record is very good as well. So it'd be really interesting to hear his ideas on that side. So, but yeah, I'm delighted. I don't really know him that well. Played against, obviously, a Sri Lankan team. But everyone I've spoken to about him, we had a beer with Brendan and the New Zealand guys after the Test match, and he spoke very highly of him as well. Yeah, it was a fantastic week at Lords. You know, both sides played really well, and it was a really good Test match to watch. And I'm glad that it is. We get great support when we come up here in Headingley with the Western Chairs the first 3 days, and it's great fun watching them with their snakes and stuff. So it's we are very lucky with how we're supported, and I'm glad there's lots of Russia tickets. It was just a really good week for everyone. As I said at the end of the game, you know, it was a rocky couple of weeks for England off the field. And yes, we're still in limbo until obviously Trevor turns up. But the way Paul has taken the side, and he's done a fantastic job. And you know, the challenge for us players now is, can we back up a great performance, or especially the last 3 days of that Test match? Can we back that up here at Headingley and try and win the series? Look, it was a great Test match for Ben. He stood up. We know how much potential he's got, and the amount of talent you see in the nets and around. His attitude's fantastic, and he thoroughly deserved that Test match for the amount of hard work he's put into his game. Yeah, he's had a slightly rocky road in terms of, you know, having a great series in Australia when we struggled, but a bit of a tough time after that. And the way he's worked his game improved. It was just a fantastic Test match, and to be there at the other end when he was playing like he was a real privilege. As always with batting, you're always fraught with danger, aren't you? One ball away from always getting out. So it's you know, you can't look too far ahead, and you know your job as an opening batter, as a batter, is to score runs. So you know, however nice it will be if I do score 30, 31, 32, whatever it is, to pass the great man, you know, that won't be enough for the game. You know, we're talking, you know, you want to sell out with big hundreds and big scores. So, you know, if I'm lucky enough to get that, it'll be a moment which I'll remember. But you know, and obviously in the game situation, it's important that if I am 30 not out, I try and go on and get a bigger score. I wouldn't be here or anywhere near me without Gucci's help. So you know, it'd be slightly strange if I do go past his record, because without his hard work and his dedication to me in my game, then I wouldn't have scored half the runs I would have done. So it's a bit of a strange one, really. But it'll be a great moment if it happens. But there'll always only ever be one Graham Gooch, that's for certain, and he's England's best ever batter.